Hi everyone, it's my first time talking face to face to you, even though, yes, well, I'm always talking to a camera, but I think it's my first time showing my face and talking to you. But I wanted to introduce this video this way. I would like to film more this type of content, so me talking to you, when I only show my hands, for example my studio vlogs or videos or when I set up my bullet journal, I am disconnected to you. I don't know if it does make sense, but I always find myself enjoying more videos where the creator talks to me and it feels like she or he is a close friend and I'm having an actual conversation. I hope it's not so awkward. I don't even know if I'm filming the right way, if I'm showing my face or I'm cutting my head out of the frame. I'm sorry, and I think you will find me look at the camera a lot because here I have the screen and I'm always checking if I'm filming the wall beside me or actually myself. Talking about the video, a few weeks ago I think I was showing my desk through my stories on Instagram at Blossom Bujo, and I think that I was cutting stickers for my Etsy shop, and a lot of you were interested in my desk and asked me to show where I work, how I work. Instead of showing it through stories, it would have been a little bit difficult and long. I thought of filming YouTube video showing you my desk / workspace would have been better. So today I'm going to show you the way I store all my materials that I use for my bullet journal and my sticker shop. I hope you enjoy it and don't expect anything because my room is quite small and my workspace is actually my bedroom. I don't have a studio, not yet. That will be my dream. I have to stick to my bedroom, so it's small. Unfortunately, I have a lot of obsession. I'm a hard fan of nail art, of makeup, of manga. I have lots of manga that I collected through the years, so there's small space for everything. It's small, but I try to make it functioning as much as I can. We'll see next time. I switch to sort of a mix of voiceover and showing you the things. You will hear me talking again, but face to face. We will see each other next time. And I hope this introduction wasn't too awkward for you. I'm actually, I think I already said it, but I'm a shy person. To be honest, it's sort of like coming out, but well, of course, not that way. No one here where I live, and it's a small city, knows that I am a creator, that I am Blossom Bujo, and all the things that I do. Only my boyfriend, my mother, my brother, and my close circle of friends. So eight, nine people. So it's my first time showing you my face, and I don't even know if people from this city will see my video in any way, but I'm quite nervous right now, because if anyone in any way will encounter this video, will recognize myself. As I said, it's a small city, so we all know each other. If you know me, hi, I'm Natalie. I hope next time I will be less awkward and more direct. And so, bye-bye. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you. So, this is the first corner that I'm going to show you. It's a mess. Please, don't bother with it, because I only keep things that I don't know where to keep anywhere else in the bedroom. Here is one of my printer. It's quite a cheap one from HP. It's the HP DeskJet 3762. I only use this for documents, printing envelopes and things that I know that I don't need a lot of quality. It's a small one. Here, this is case for this camera, the one that I'm filming right now, the video. I usually keep my camera here where I don't record. This is the box where I keep all of my sticker flakes or sticker set. I don't think that I will keep these a lot. I will search on Amazon or local stores if they have something a little bit more quality and not with plastic. This is quite old, I think. That my mom bought me this when I was 6-7 years old. Yes, so quite old. But I couldn't find anything else around the house to keep all of my single stickers. Here I keep all of this spare ink. I usually try, of course, not to run out of ink, so I bought a lot of ink cartridges, and these ones are for my Canon, and this one is for the printer that I just showed you, so the HP. Here, as you can see, I'm showing you one of my other obsessions, that is makeup. Of course, I won't show you everything, but as you can see, it's taking quite space in my room. Anyway, this is my tray, the tray that I bought from Amazon, and I actually filmed a video where I fill it with all of my stationery. I will leave the link, I think, here in the cards or down below in the info box. It's quite easy to move it around, so if I need it to be near my desk, for example when I cut the stickers or when I packaging sticker, it's easy to move it. I didn't change a lot since that video, so I will quickly show you the things, and if you want an in-depth video, you can click that. Here I keep all of my stickers, my art prints and my envelopes, and yep, this is the stamp set from Notebook Therapy. Here I keep all of my old brush pens. I bought them before I even opened my Blossom Buja account, because I bullet journaled for a year before opening Blossom Buja, and these were the only markers and brush pens that I owned at the time. So they are old, and all of them are generic brand from Amazon. Here I keep washi tapes and single stickers, as you can see, that I bought from AliExpress. Here I have lots of them. As you can see, it's easy to collect things from AliExpress because they cost nothing. Down below there's another tray, so there are three different trays filled with stickers and washi tapes. Here it's the cutter that I use for small things for my shop. Here I have my washi tape collection. I just put everything here. I don't really use a lot of washi tape anymore in my Buja. I tend to use them for my pen pals. I don't find myself searching for washi tapes a lot. Here I have the alphabet stamps and the bullet journal stencil from Notebook Therapy. Here I have Tsuki pop-up pencil case. I'm actually using their pencil case in tan. It's one from the winter collection, if I remember correctly. I usually like to switch up them to match my bullet journal theme. Here I have the honey color, the lilac color. Here I have all of my memo pads, as you can see. As for my washi tapes, I just use them for my pen pals. I don't find myself using them a lot. Here I keep all of my sticker sheet. I filmed a video where I showed you how I keep them, so I leave the video up here. These are stickers from small businesses. At the bottom, I have all of the stickers that I bought from AliExpress. Final part of the tray. Here I keep all of the notebooks that I own. At the end, I have the notebooks that I have already used. For example, this is my first bullet journal. Here I have notebooks that I still need to use it. This is going to be my next bullet journal, the one from July to December, I think. I have all of my pen pals, the ones that I have already replied to. And here I have miscellaneous things. These were sent to me by Arteza. That is, I bought them from Amazon. This is from Pepperang. It's a thermal printer. Okay, here I quickly show you. This is a mess, sorry. This is my old printer. I don't use it anymore, so bye. I'm just keeping it here because I don't know where to put it. Over here I have normal office paper and a thicker paper. This is my new paper cutter. This is a lifesaver. I use it for all of my memo pads to cut all of my branding stickers, and it's easy. There's nothing much to show you, just a mess. Under my desk there's this little tray. Here I just keep all of this sticker paper. There's matte paper, there's vinyl paper, and here it's matte photo paper. Here I keep things for my shop. Plastic envelope, my envelopes, as you can see there's a lot. This is a tape that was sent to me by No Issue. And here they are the boxes that Not Therapy sent when you order them their notebook. It's good to reuse things. All of my branding stickers. Here I have other envelopes. So these are the back cards for my sticker set. Here I have the wrapping paper from No Issue. On the other side, don't mind the trash cans. On the other side, under the desk, I have my actual printer, the Canon Pixma TS5063, and the quality is amazing. I highly suggest you this printer if, for example, you want to start a business or you want a good printer at home. Ho, I know that you were all waiting for this part. This is my desk. I'm here sitting at my desk for 10 hours per day, even more. I'm always here. This is my holy space. Let's dive in. Hello. This is my computer. These are all scratches. The screen is basically ruined forever. It's not my fault, actually. This is an old computer that my father possessed. He lives in France. He sent me through the post. I think that along the way from France to Italy, even though it's a short journey, someone didn't trip this computer the right way. When I opened my package, I found this mess. But it's okay, I even didn't pay for it. It works, it's not a problem. These are a lifesaver. I always listen to music when I work. As I already told you, I work at home. At home I have my brother and my mother, and of course they need to live at home and they make noises. So I need to listen to music to concentrate and being able to work peacefully. This is a Bluetooth keyboard and a Bluetooth mouse. Behind this computer I have my Silhouette machine. I don't know where to keep this machine. It's quite a burden. Found this little corner and I usually keep it here when I'm not working. When I work I simply grab it and put it here on my desk and cut my stickers. It's not really convenient, but I can't do anything else. These are all of the things that Kawaii Pen Shop sent me. I filmed unboxing with me and I keep them here because I still want to film some videos and do things with them, so it's temporary. Moving on, I have my trusty iPad. This is where all the magic happens. This is an iPad 10.5 inches, one from 2019. This is the first Apple Pencil generation pen. Here I draw and do all the things for my Etsy shop. And here I have my bullet journal. I keep it on my desk, so every time I need to write on my weeklies, etc., I simply grab it, fill it. This is the pencil case, the Tsuki pop-up in tan, the one that I was talking before when I was showing you my stationery tray. Here I keep all of the brush pens and pens that I use for this month. And ta-da! This is a pen box storage. It's handmade. I was able to come up with this thanks to my lovely friend Kat Planner. She made a tutorial where she showed how to create this box from a foam board. These are all of my pens. They are quite a lot. Of course, I separated them by colors. As you can see here, it's falling down, but it's actually my fault. When I built this, I realized that there was a little bit space here, so this foam board and this one weren't actually connected through hot glue, but it was something like 2-3 millimeters, so I said, well, it's not a problem, such a small space, so what can I do? And after a year, here I am, it's falling down. The gap is definitely bigger now, and the weight of the brush pens are pushing this foam board the way. So I need to find a solution before I woke up one day and I have all of my brush pen on the floor. Wish me luck. And these are the ones that I use the most. Red, pink, orange, yellow, green, green, blue, blue, purple, brown. These are all of my black and grey brush pens, fineliners, gel pens, etc, etc. Even a white pen, as you can see, from Posca Pen. Eyeliners from Chameleon. And here I have all of the pen pals that I still need to reply to. And these are here to remind me every day that I need to write to them. I'm sorry if you're one of my pen pals, it's taking me such a long time. Usually writing a pen pals takes me something like 3 hours, even 4, I don't know why. It's difficult to find an entire afternoon or morning. Don't worry, I haven't forgotten you. You are here, I see you every day, and I will reply to you as soon as I can. So this is my bedroom, my workspace and desk. I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you find it helpful and interesting, and see you next time. Bye bye.